Ladies, welcome to our studio.
Thank you for having us.
It's our pleasure. Mariana, you're the president of Investors Beyond Borders, a student association affiliated with the University of Toronto. Mm-hmm. Tell us about Investors Beyond Borders. Mm-hmm.
Well, like you said, we are a nonprofit student organization located at the University of Toronto, and we are an international student organization where we have a network established within four continents and five universities around the world. And so our student organization pretty much asks members to find their gem. And what that stands for is Find Your Green Emerging Market. We are a student organization that has a focus on emerging markets and investments in the renewable energy sectors in these nations.
In other words, go green.
Go green.
Go green. That's perfect. I understand that you have an initiative, and it's International Renewable Energy Case Competition. Tell me about it.
Okay. Well, the International Renewable Energy Case Competition is the world's first and the world's largest case competition dedicated to finding investment opportunities in the renewable energy markets of emerging nations. And so what this, the way that this works is we decided to focus on an emerging nation, and we are focusing on the nation of Macedonia this year. And the way that it works is our affiliates in all of our five universities around the world will get to study the region of Macedonia, mm-hmm. study the industry, the renewable energy industry, and they'll get to pretty much try and find investment opportunities within Macedonia's energy industry. And so students are going to be required to submit investment proposals mm-hmm. on which energy would be the best, the most suitable for the region.
Right. That's very interesting. Catherine, what is your role with Investors Beyond Borders?
Well, I'm the International Relations Director, and what I do is I contact all the universities around the world in our four continents, and I get in contact with them, and I keep a close connection with them, making sure that they establish their own first round competition.
Okay. Your organization is represented in, we said, five different countries?
Yes.
Tell us about them.
Well, each country will be having their own first round competition. There they'll have their own info sessions, getting students from their own university. They'll create their own business plan, and which they'll be their own host for this competition. Their students who will win will be rewarded a trip, an all-inclusive trip to Macedonia for 7 days.
Wow, that's interesting. And do you know anything about the trip though?
Mm-hmm. So what we're going to be doing in Macedonia is the teams with the best business plans mm-hmm. or the best investment proposals will get to travel to Macedonia to see if their investment proposal is actually viable and can be implemented. So when they're in Macedonia, they're going to travel the region. They're going to travel the north region, the south, the east, the west. They'll meet with various individuals from the public administration, various organizations already investing in Macedonia to figure out what's their comparative advantage for choosing Macedonia. And once they're there, there's going to be kind of a shock that the teams will have to overcome, and the best investment proposal from there will win a prize, a monetary prize that will go towards funding their education.
Perfect. How did you come up with this idea?
Well, the idea actually just came. What happened was I have a background working at the University of Toronto. I was the Minister of Environment in my previous years, and last year I was the Vice President University Affairs and Academics for the Student Council there. And so my responsibility was to figure out ways to enhance the environment and the sustainability on our campus. And so this year I thought, you know what, Macedonia is having an energy crisis where, you know, they have a shortage of about 70% where they import their energy, and it's also a nation where it's continually trying to go green, in other words, mm-hmm. and trying to attract clean energy investments. And so we decided this is a perfect and amazing opportunity to take Macedonia as an emerging nation and then take this industry where so many leaders around the world are trying to bring forward, and that's how the idea developed.
Amazing idea, and I wouldn't say I hope, I know it's going to work. How young people can join this mm-hmm. this competition? Mm-hmm.
Well, the competition timeline, what happens is next month, November, students are able to create their teams and sign up online. They can, our website is investorsbeyondborders.com, and so they will have an opportunity to sign up their team online. And for the period until November 2009 to March 2010, they will have an opportunity to develop their investment proposals and present in March 2010. Now, the teams that win in March 2010 will then get to travel to Macedonia in May 2010. Right.
Catherine, do you have to be a student of the University of Toronto to join this?
No, actually. The students of the University of Toronto will be competing. Also, we are including all GTA universities, including Ryerson and York, to name the bigger ones, and they will have their own group of students that will be competing against the University of Toronto to win this trip.
Well, okay, let's see. And this is ending when? You have the timeline, right?
Like I said, in March 2010, the first round presentations occur, and the best teams that win in March will then get to travel to Macedonia in May 2010.
Thank you so much, girls, for having you today, and I wish you all the best, and let the best one wins.
Thank you, Maya.
Thank you.